गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैड डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग द जनरल प्रिंसिपल ऑफ मैनेजमेंट। टुडे वी हैव टू डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ साइंटिफिक मैनेजमेंट विच वॉज गिवेन बाय एफ डब्ल्यू टॉयलर हु वॉज नोन एज द फादर ऑफ साइंटिफिक मैनेजमेंट। बिफोर डिस्कसिंग साइंटिफिक प्रिंसिपल ऑफ साइंटिफिक मैनेजमेंट वी नो अबाउट हिम। ही वॉज अपॉइंटेड एज ए अप्रेंटिसशिप केमिस्ट इन मिडाभेल स्टील कंपनी इन USA। देन ही वॉज प्रमोटेड टू सुपरवाइजर। ड्यूरिंग दिस पीरियड ही वॉज स्टडीड एज कंप्लीटेड द मेकैनिकल इंजीनियर। देन ही इज अपॉइंटेड एज ए मेकैनिकल इंजीनियर इन बेथलहेम स्टील कंपनी इन USA। On the basis of his observation and experience, he wrote many papers and books. At that time, he also wrote the book Principle of Scientific Management in 1911, which was very popular at that time, and everyone had appreciated it. Now you know about the meaning and principle of scientific management. Scientific management means we exactly know what men want to do and seeing that the workers are working on the prescribed way or in the best and cheapest way. The principles are divided into four parts. Number one, that is your implementation of science in place of rule of thumb. Number two, harmony not discord. Number three, cooperation not individualism. Number four, development of each and every worker. Now come to number one, implementation of science in place of rule of thumb part suggested. Rule of thumb means trial and error method. In this case, the workers trying again and again to do the job, at last he may reach or may not reach in the perfection. In this way, the organizations lost various resources. But after implementation of science, we apply the prescribed rule for getting the results. And in this way, we have to save many resources. And we also increasing the production capacity of the organization. Number two, harmony not discord. Harmony means good relationship between workers and management. Both are most understood that they are required for each other. The management required to workers and the worker also required to management. If any conflict arises between them, they must be solved immediately. Otherwise, it causes heavy losses for the organization. Number three, cooperation not individualism. There is a close cooperation between the workers and management. The management must give due respect to the workers for their productive suggestions and grievances. If the suggestions and grievances are very good or appropriate for the organization, they must be implemented in the organization for doing the work, and the worker also must be rewarded by the management in terms of financial incentives or non-financial incentives. Number four, development of each and every worker. He gives more importance on the development of workers. The workers must be developed in two ways, in the potential abilities and in the prosperity. Potential abilities developed through training, and prosperity will be possible with the help of your education facilities, medical facilities, housing facilities, and other facilities provided to the workers. Both are required to the workers. In this way, the management extract his full potential in the production way. Now we have to discuss regarding the techniques of scientific management, which was also suggested by the F.D. Tyler. The techniques of scientific management, he has suggested four points. That is number one, functional foremanship. Number two, work study. Number three, standardization of work. And number four, that is your differential piece rate wages system. Now we have to come functional foremanship. In order to bring specialization at lower level of management, he divided the work into two parts, that is office and shop. Office also office entrusted to 4% and shop also entrusted to 4%. In this way, a worker is guided by 8%. The office is entrusted 4% there, that is your route clerk, time and cost clerk, instruction card clerk and disciplinary clerk. Route clerk suggested that in which way the raw material will be passed for production, or the prescribed way of passing the raw materials for production. And number two, that is your time and cost clerk, that is mean the time required to perform the job and cost involving it, which is very essential for the organization. And in scientific management, they play a vital role, that is your cost and time. And number three, that is your instruction card clerk, give instruction to the workers to do the work in the prescribed way or the on the plan way. Then disciplinary clerk, it maintain discipline at the workplace, which is very essential in the organization. Then come to shop. Shop also entrusted to 4%, that is your gang boss, speed boss, maintenance boss and inspector. The work of the gang boss is arrangement of all the equipments and resources required for performing the work or before starting the work. That means all the machines and equipments are properly arranged by the foreman before starting the work. Then speed boss, maintenance of proper speed of the machines and equipments decided by the management. And number three, that is your maintenance boss. The work of the maintenance is proper greasing and oiling the machines and machines and equipments. That means keeping the machines and equipments in the proper condition. And next year, that is your inspector boss, to see the works are performed on the basis of planning or on the basis of standard fixed by the management or not, and providing guidelines to them to do the work on the basis of standard or plan fixed by the management. And in this way, a worker is guided by 8% and every foreman is enough competent in his work only. If any problem faced by workers at the workplace, the respective or the concerned foreman will help to the workers for removing the problems or removing the hurdles at the work point. In this way, the organization will run the works very smoothly. This is about your functional foremanship. Then come to work study. Work study means analysis of every work to find out the best way for doing the job. That means it is the combination of method study, time study, motion study and fatigue study. The method study means find out the best way to do the job. Time study means the required time to perform the assigned job. Motion study to eliminate the unnecessary motions by the workers at the workplace. Fatigue study, providing rest hour to the workers after certain intervals. We have discussed all the points in detail in the general class. Then come to, that is your standardization. Standardization means using best quality of products by using standard quality of machines, equipments, raw materials and proper working conditions. If all our machines, equipments and working condition is good, definitely the workers will produce standard quality of goods which is accepted by the consumers. Then differential piece rate wages system.
Differential piece wage system suggested that the workers will be rewarded on the basis of their production. That means he divided the workers into three parts. That is efficient, inefficient, and semi-efficient. For example, A, B, C are three workers. A produce 500 units of product, B produce 400 units of product, and C produce 300 units of product. And the management fixed the price for the unit is rupees 5. In this way, A will get rupees 2500, B will get 2000, and C will get 1500. That means 2000, A will get 2000 means C is efficient workers and C is very inefficient workers. Now C will try their best to get more salary and wages in the future. So in this way, he also develop his ability for doing the job. This is about today, and in next period we have discussed regarding the differentiation between toiler general principle of management and toiler principle of management. Thank you. Have a nice day.